strength's almighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. He made the trees, he made the seas, he made the elephants too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. So strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are his, the valleys are his, the stars are his handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
Looks weird. I wonder who could have made it.
Willard, what are you doing?
Oh, Herm, you scared me.
Sorry, I didn't mean to.
Oh, it's okay. Anyways, I was just looking at this peculiar tower of blocks.
What makes it so, peculiar?
Well, it just looks a little lopsided, don't you think?
That's because it is lopsided.
Oh. I don't understand. Why is it like that?
Well, Winnie and I were playing with the blocks, and we were trying to build this tower super tall. But she just wouldn't follow my plan for the tower, so it got a little lopsided.
Oh, sounds like you might have been fighting about the plans.
Yes, we were.
Did you know, Herm, that God's plan is actually the best plan?
God has a plan for my tower of blocks?
Well, not exactly, but he has a plan for each of our lives that we should follow and obey, and God's plan is best. Hey, I think we should learn more about that today. It could be our special one thing. Let's all say it together, everyone. Ready?
God's plan is best. But how is that going to help me with this tower?
Oh, I don't think it will. But there is a true Bible story about people who were also trying to build a tower and not following God's plan. Let's go see if our friends Grandma and Grandpa know the story.
Did you hear what I said? I said that the Bible has some crazy stories.
Say what?
I said the Bible has some crazy stories.
I know. What kind of stories?
Say what? What stories?
I think I have a Bible story I can share.
That's what I was gonna say. I'll go make some tea. You go ahead and start telling these youngins your story.
Oh, hey there, kiddos. I didn't see you there. I think you know my grandson, Steve. He loves sharing all those Bible stories, and he told me that you're all such good listeners. Can you put on those good listening ears for me? I have to warn you, I don't hear so well, so I might need your help with some of the story. I want you all to imagine a super duper tall tower. Think of a tower that goes all the way up into the sky. Well, now there lived this group of people who wanted to build a tower. Not just any tower, but a gigantic tower that would reach all the way into the sky. But that was not part of God's plan for them. God didn't want them to do that, and they didn't listen to his plan. They forgot that. God's plan is best. I think that's the best thing to remember from today's story. Let's say it together. God's plan is best. This place was called Babylon. Can you guys say that? Babylon. Isn't that a funny name? And the tower they built was going to be called the Tower of Babel. Can you guys say that with me? Tower of Babel. What? I didn't hear you. Tower of Babel. Well, here's the not so good part. The reason they wanted to build a tower that reached up and into the heavens was because they thought that they didn't need God, and that they were better than him. But God's plan is best. Say it with me. God's plan is best. Let's read about the Tower of Babel in the Bible now. At one time, all the people of the world spoke the same language and used the same words. Then they said, "Come, let's build a great city for ourselves, with a tower that reaches into the sky. This will make us famous and keep us from being scattered all over the world." This is a very bad thing to think that they were putting themselves before God. We can't do anything without God because he gives us all our strength. God told them to spread out over the earth, but they didn't want to listen. That's why they wanted to show that they thought they were just as good as God with their plan for the giant tower. But God's plan is always best. One thing about God's plan is that they always also come true. If he says something's going to happen, then you know it'll happen for sure. Hey, that's just like last week when we learned that God always keeps his promises. God doesn't ever lie to us. Let's see what he does to make sure his plans come true. But the Lord came down to look at the city and the tower the people were building. "Look," he said, "the people are united, and they all speak the same language. After this, nothing they set out to do will be impossible for them. Come, let's go down and confuse the people with different languages. Then they won't be able to understand each other." He made them all speak different languages. When you don't know what someone is saying, we say they are babbling. They couldn't understand each other, so they couldn't keep building the tower together. They had to scatter around the world just like God's first plan. God's plan is best. Say what? God's plan is best. We have to remember that God's plan for our lives is the best plan. And we may not know what His plan for us is exactly, but we can remember that He has a good, pleasing, and perfect plan for each of us. He created us that way. God wants us to ask Him for the plan in our lives. He wants us to make Him the leader of our lives and then pray to Him to find out how we can follow His amazing plan. God's plan is best. Say what? God's plan is best. Well, that's all I got for you youngins today. I hope you learned something real special. Remember to always follow God's plan. Bye-bye now. Have a great rest of your week. Wow, God's plan was so crazy. Did He really want them all to spread out across all of the lands?
Yep, He wanted His people to fill up the earth.
Well, why didn't they want to then?
Well, because they thought they didn't need God. But if God says something is going to happen, we know that it will. He always keeps His promises.
So we should always listen to Him and trust that His plan is best?
That's right, Herm.
Can we go tell Winnie what we learned today? Maybe then we can work on the Tower of Blocks together.
Well, that's a great idea. But before we go, let's all practice our one thing together. God's plan is best. Ready?
God's plan is best.
Now let's go find Winnie.
Hey kids, I'm Christy. Before we end today, let's practice our memory verse and then we'll pray. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful to teach us what is true. 2 Timothy 3:16. Let's all say, God's plan is best. Ready? God's plan is best. Let's all pray. Put your hands together and bow your head. Dear God, thank you that your plan for my life is the best plan out there. Help me to always follow it. Amen. See you next week!